CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 3.
Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are fine at home and keeping safe. I am Pooja Rana, your math teacher. As we all know, schools are closed, but learning never stops. So, we are here to learn a very interesting maths topic today. So children, today we are going to learn a very interesting topic from Maths Magic Grade 3 book, that is Chapter 1, Where to Look From. Before we start, have you looked at the book on the table? Does it always look the same or different every time when you look at it? Think. Yes, I know your answer. No, it does not look the same always. It looks different from different sides. So what does it mean from different sides? It means if we look at the book on the table from the front side, then we can see only a rectangular box. But if we see the book on the table from the top or from the height, then we can see a rectangular flat box lying on the table. So children, it means we can see some part of the book at some time. Sometimes we can see only its width. Sometimes we can see only its length. Or sometimes we can see length and width both at the same time. But it will depend on the position from which where are we watching the book. So do you know why it is happening? Okay, let me tell you first what do we have in our chapter today. Here is a small incident of classroom activity by a student that is mentioned in the chapter. If you have textbook with you, then you can open the textbook, and if you don't have the textbook, then you don't need to bother. I will explain the incident to you. A child is explaining an incident of his classroom. Here it goes. Our teacher told us to draw a picture of a car. We all drew the car differently. Next day, when we showed our pictures to each other, we were very excited. But Anshul started laughing. He was looking at Dheeraj's drawing of a car. Anshul said, "It looks like a small box kept in a bigger box." Then Anshul showed his drawing to Dheeraj. Both of them drew the picture of the same car, but the drawings looked different. Anshul said that Dheeraj's drawing looked like a small box in a bigger box. So children, can you visualize the Dheeraj's drawing and tell me why he drew the car like a small box kept in a bigger one? Think about it. Is Dheeraj's drawing funny or right? Think. Children, both the drawings are different. But both the drawings are right. Do you know why? Dheeraj told to his friend Anshul that he had looked at the car from the terrace. That is from the top. So that's how Dheeraj explained why his drawing is different from others. Dheeraj had looked at the car from the terrace. This is why he drew the top view of the car, because he was at the top. Anshul had looked at the car from the side. This is why he drew the side view of the car. So children, can you visualize the picture of a car if you will look at the car from the side? Think in your mind. Try to watch the picture. How does the car look? Yes, you can see the two tires of the car. You can see one front seat of the car, which is followed by the other seat of the car. I guess you can see in the side view one headlight, front headlight of the car, and backlight of the car as well. Okay. Now imagine, if you are at Dheeraj's position, you watch a car from the top. Then how will it look? Imagine. Yes, it will look like a small box kept in a bigger box. So now you understand why Dheeraj drew a smaller box in a bigger box. So children, we look at the things from different views or sides, and this is why they look differently to us. So that is why our chapter's name is also Where to Look From. So children, now I will ask you some question and you will tell me. Have you looked at the things from different sides? Do they look the same or different? Yes, if you change the view position, the thing will look different to you. Now imagine a table. Do you know what is a table? A flat rectangular box placed on the four legs. So, now imagine a table. Does the table look the same or different from the different sides? No, it will not look the same. If we see a table from the top, then what will we see? I repeat, if we see a table from the top, then what will we see? Think. Yes, we will see a rectangular flat box. But can we see its legs also? Think. No, legs will not be visible. Okay, now tell me, if we will see the same table from the front, then what will we see? I repeat, if we see the same table from the front, then what part of the table will be visible to us? Come on, think. Yes, you are right. Now, we will be able to see its legs also. But now, this time, that rectangular big box will be turned into a small, narrow-shaped long line. It will look just like a ruler. Yes, it will just look like a ruler. Do you know ruler? Scale in your geometry box. Yes. Now we will take one more example. What do we carry when it rains? Tell me. Yes, umbrella, you are right. Children, now visualize its picture in your mind. So, which shape of umbrella did you see? Yes, half circle. Yes, if we open the umbrella, then half circle followed by a rod that is curved at the ending point where we hold it. Yes, you have a bright picture. So children, I know that many of us had seen the same picture, only a half circle and a rod. So what do you think? From which side we have imagined the umbrella? The picture we saw in our mind, it was which side? Yes, it was the front side of the umbrella. Now imagine if you are at the terrace of your house and watching a girl holding a umbrella in her hands, then what view will you see? Think. Yes, we will see a circle now. Now the half circle is gone and a big round circle is there. So that picture of the same umbrella changes with the change in the position. Okay children, now imagine how these things will look if seen from the top. Imagine a pressure cooker. Imagine, I know you must have seen the pressure cooker in the kitchen. So, if you will watch it from the top, what part will you see? A thin layered line with black handle or a big circular lid with a flat handle? Yes, we will see a big circular lid with a flat handle. Now imagine a spoon. A spoon from the top. What part will you see? An oval shaped deep thing joined with a narrow flat shaped handle or only a broad flat circular part? Yes, we will be able to see a big oval shaped circle followed by a line. Now imagine a glass. Which part you will able to see from the top? Yes, we will be able to see a small circle put in the bigger circle. Now children, we will take some more examples to understand the different views of the same object. Imagine the side view of a bus. What things can be seen in the side view of the bus? Think. Yes, a long rectangular surface with a row of seats and two tires also can be seen. And if we see the front view of the same bus, then we can see only the front surface of the bus with driver's seat and front two tires. And if we see the same bus from the top, then no seats can be seen. Only top roof part of the bus will be visible to us. Children, now think of a sparrow. Have you seen a sparrow? Yes, the sparrow is sitting on the ground. So, if we see the sparrow from the side, then only one eye, side view of the beak, A tail and legs can be seen from this side. But if we see the bird from the front, then bird's complete face with a small part of its body and two little legs can be seen. But what if we look at the bird from the terrace? Then we can see its tiny legs. Yes, only its head and upper body with tail can be seen. We will take one more example to understand the different views. You all must be having pencil with you. Now, look at the pencil from the top, from the side, and from the front. Are all the sides look the same or different? Yes, you are right. All the three views are different. When we see the pencil from the top, then only a circle with a dot can be seen. In the side view, a narrow rectangular pointed tip from one end can be seen. And in the front view, a pointed tip with a wooden circular shape can be seen. So children, we have discussed three views till now: side view, front view, and top view. Now, I will give few description of some objects to you, and you will tell me that I am talking about which view of the object or from where I am seeing that object. So, it is a game. Are you ready? Yes. First, it is a ladder and I can see a straight bamboo only. So, from where am I looking at the ladder? Think. Yes, I am looking at the ladder from the side. It is a side view. Very good. Next, it is a staircase and I can see some bigger steps in the starting, and steps are getting smaller and smaller up to the last. So tell me the view. Where am I standing? Yes, I am watching the staircase from the front. It is a front view. One more. It is a helicopter and I can see its fan with the blades and its body under the fan. So now tell me, from where can I see this view? Yes, it is the top view of the helicopter. You are very good. Now, one more. It is a bicycle and I can see two circular tires with one handle and one pedal only. So, tell me the view. Think. Yes, it is the side view of the cycle. Next, it is a tree, a big tree, and I can see dense green leaves all around, but cannot see the ground. So tell me its view. Think. Yes, it is the top view of the tree. Great going, children. Next, it is a bottle, a water bottle. I can see a small circle kept in a bigger circle. So tell me, which view is it? Yes, it is the top view of the bottle. It is a leaf, green leaf, a banana leaf. I can see a curved green long line only. So tell me the view. Thing, it is a much tacky. Yes, it is the side view of the banana leaf. So children, do you like the game? I hope you liked it. You can observe these different views of different objects all around you. We are surrounded with lots of things and objects that are having many views. For example, you can see houses, buildings, furniture in your house, things in your school bags, utensils in the kitchen, and many more. So, we have to just look at them carefully and observe the changes in the different views of the same object. How does the image changes with the change in the view? Think over it and observe the three views, and maybe more views are there. Now we will play one more game. Are you ready? Okay, so let us start. This time, I will give you the view of the object and you have to tell me about how does it look. So, let us play the game. Okay, top view of an ant. Imagine an ant and think how does it look when you look at it from the top. Yes. Two black dots joined together and six hairy legs can be seen. Good. Now, side view of the ant. Imagine what things can be seen from the side. Yes, two dots again joined together, but this time only three legs can be seen. Now, front view of a rat. Imagine a rat and you are standing front of it. How does it look? What parts can you see? Can you see its face? Yes. Can you see its tail? No. Can you see its all the four legs? No. Only two legs can be seen. Wow, you are going so great. Okay, side view of a bangle. Take your mother's bangle and put it on the table. Now see from the side. What can we see? Only a curved line. Now, top view of the bucket. Look at the bucket in the washroom. Look from the top. How does it look like? Yes, it looks like a small circle kept in a bigger circle. Side view of a train. Children, just imagine the side view of the train. How does it look like? Think. A long chain of boxes joined together in a line. Okay, children, now I have a problem for you. Listen to me carefully. From which view we cannot count the number of coaches of the train? From which view we cannot count the coaches of the train? Think and tell me. Yes, you are absolutely right. From the front view. From the front view, we cannot count the coaches of a train because we cannot see its length from the front view. But if we look at the train from the top or from the side, then we can count the number of coaches of the train. Now, some task for you. It is the time to storm your brain. So children, today we have learnt about the different views of any object and how they changes when the view or sight changed. Now I have some brainstorming exercise for you. Can you think of an object which will look the same from all the sides or views? Confused? Think. I repeat, you have to think an object which will look the same from all the sides. Think and observe carefully around you. I am sure you will be able to find few things that does not change when we change the side. Okay, I give you a hint. Okay, I am giving you one hint. Football. Yes, if we see a football from the top, we will see a circle. If we see football from the front, again we will see a circle. And what will we see if we see it from the side? Again a circle. So now you have to list few objects that does not change its look when the sides change. So isn't it interesting? Yes. Time for the activity to do at home. I am giving you a situation and you have to visualize the view. A cat is peeping into a classroom and it can see black heads all around. Can you help her to find out where the teacher is and from where? A cat is peeping into the classroom and it can see black heads only all around. Can you help her to find out where the teacher is? Imagine the scene and draw the picture and think from where the cat is peeping into the classroom. One more. I have one more task for you. It is a game that you can play with your friends or your siblings. Draw the top views of a few things and ask your friends to guess what they are, and it will be fun. Dear children, I hope you liked today's session. I hope you enjoyed all the games and activities we did together. Hope to see you soon again. With these words, I am closing today's session. Goodbye.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.